So this is my bao recipe, which is basically a bun.
We needing 2.5 cups of flour. This is 1/3 cup of water, warm, and then warm milk. This is about 1/2 cup. So the temperature should be about 120 degrees below, not above 120 degrees. Otherwise, our yeast will die. This is 1 tablespoon of yeast and 1 tablespoon of sugar for the yeast mixture. This will serve as the food of the yeast. And then this is 2 tablespoons of oil. Any oil will do. And then 1 tablespoon that we will be using later. So this is 3 tablespoons of sugar, 1.5 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Just checking the temperature of our water, it should be about 120, so right now it's 150, so we'll wait a while for it to go down before starting. Equipment, you will be needing your mixer. This is optional, with your dough hook. And then we'll be needing a steamer. So while waiting for the water and the milk to warm, what I did was I covered the lid with a cloth, and then wax paper for your steamer. And then you will be needing rolling pin, big and small, if you have your rubber spatula, your wax paper and your cling wrap, and then your bench scrapers,
a round cutter at least 2 inches.
Our temperature reading is now at 110. So it's already 110. So that's a very good temperature for the yeast. So we'll be adding our water, warm water. Our warm milk. Our yeast, our 1 tablespoon of sugar that will serve as the food of the yeast, and then our oil. So we'll mix this and set it aside, and we'll go back after around 5 to 10 minutes, depending on the yeast condition.
So our yeast has been proofed already. So to the mixer, we will be adding our dry ingredients, the flour, sugar, baking powder, salt. We'll just mix this. So the yeast has been proofed. We'll just add this to the dry ingredients. So I'll just be attaching my dough hook and mix this until combined. So this is a very sticky dough. So one characteristics that I will be looking is that it is webby. It looks like a web. I really don't know if webby is a word, As long as you know what it means, it looks like a web. So we don't agitate the dough very much. So as I've said, this is sticky. So I'll just form a ball. So I'll just cover this and place this bowl in the warmest part of my kitchen. I will check on this after an hour. So after an hour, it's time to knead and form our bows. As I've said, this is a very sticky dough, so your surface should be floured. I'll just be adding flour on the side. This is just for backup to remove the stickiness. So I'll just be kneading this for a while. As you can see, it is very sticky. That's why you will need your bench scraper. I prepared a lined tray for our cut bows. So I'll let them rise again for 30 minutes after this kneading and cutting. This dough is pillowy soft, so it is really no pressure doing the kneading. So time to roll it out, then cut into circles. Again, flour a rolling pin, then roll. So this is 1/4 inch thick. We'll just cut our circles and place them in our steamer for rising. So small bows means less carbs, that's why I'm making them small. The excess, you can form a ball again and then re-roll after resting them for at least 30 minutes. So get one of the circles, so half of it you apply oil, then gently roll your rolling pin, and that's it. You lay it to your steamer or to your tray for resting. So we'll do it again. So my camera is off focus, but I will be doing the rest. So eventually my camera will focus and you will get to see what I'm doing. the purpose of the oil is that you can easily open the bowls to put your filling. This is like your shop-out dough, but this is much easier. One more, then we're good. I'll just finish this. Rice again for 30 minutes and then steam. We are now steaming for 10 to 12 minutes. The purpose of the cloth is that water won't drip into our bowls. So let's check. This is the aha moment. We'll just get this and pleat. These are pillowy soft. Excited na to eat. So this is it with our patatim. And this is our small bite of everything. Thank you.